Hi guys, this is Sam from UberDriverNow.com. I just wanted to make a quick video of Google Maps for Uber drivers and the best features that it has that helps Uber drivers. The first thing that I wanted to show you guys is the timeline feature. If you click on this menu button right here on the top left-hand corner, there is an option here that says your timeline, and if you tap on that, it's going to show you the miles that you've driven today, and where you've been, where have you, all the locations right here, and then it shows you a little map of the routes that you took. So that's a pretty cool feature. You can actually use this information for either when you're filing your taxes, and you can use the mileage deduction, and that you were driving for Uber, and or just for your own personal information. So that's a pretty cool feature, and it has a map, and you can actually go as far back when you actually turned the feature on. So when you first log into Google Maps using your Gmail, it will actually, when you click on timeline, it will ask you to get started and allow Google Maps to use your location. And once you've turned that on, even when the app is off, it's still going to keep a track of, where you're going and everything. And they have privacy, information that tells you that, this information is not going to be used in any other way by Google. The other option that I wanted to share with you was the location sharing right here. And location sharing is really beneficial, for people who want to share their live location with their loved ones or their family or friends when they're driving for Uber, just so that they can keep a track of them. And for security reasons, so if you click get started, you can actually, on the top it says how long do you want to share the location for, and you can go up or go down for the hours, how many hours you want to share the location for, or you have this feature where it says until you turn this off, it will keep on sharing the location, all the time. Without any time limit. You can either message people and text them the location, or you can click on more here, and it basically shows you all the other apps that you have installed on your phone, social media apps and all of that, and you can email or whatnot, and you can actually send your location through any of these apps as well. So this is a pretty cool, neat feature. The recipient will receive a link. When they click on that link, it's going to take them to a Google Maps page, and it'll show them a map with your location. The other cool feature is offline maps right here. And offline maps basically allows you to download a map within this particular rectangle. You can zoom out or zoom in as much as you want, and you can see the amount of space that it will require to download this map will show up right here. So the more I zoom out, the bigger the file becomes for the offline map. And I basically have all the way up till here. It kind of covers the whole of LA and the surrounding greater Los Angeles area, all the way down to San Diego to the south, and then, all the way up to these areas that you can see on the map. And if you click download, it's going to start downloading the map for you, and it'll save. Now what this does is that even if you don't have a cell network, even if you don't have Wi-Fi or data turned on, you'll still be able to use the Google Maps, and it will still work, and just like as it was a standalone GPS, which is, this is a great option. third thing that I wanted to, or the fourth thing that I wanted to share with you guys is the feature that is the avoid tolls feature. Now, if I was to actually share, or rather, if I was to actually go to a location and I hit directions right here at the bottom, you will see, you know, how long it will take you and how many miles you are from the location. And if you click on the top right-hand corner here, the three dots, and you click on route options, here's where you can select these three different options. I basically just choose avoid tolls because that's what I want. I just don't want to go through toll roads because it's a hassle. You know, if you don't have a transponder, they're going to send you a letter in the mail saying that you use the toll roads for this many exits or whatnot, and you have to pay this much. So it's just a hassle for me. So I just avoid it, you know, in general. So when you click done, now this setting is going to be saved and it's going to show up right here. Every time you navigate somewhere, it will always avoid tolls. So this is a great feature that I find very useful. So that about covers the, you know, all the features that I can think of. If there's any others that I think of, later on, I'll make another video for it. Hope you enjoyed this video and hope you found it useful. Like, comment, and subscribe, and there'll be a lot more to come. Safe driving, guys, and until next time, take care. Bye-bye.